Or even an event in life, sometimes there's not just enough space in us to kind of assimilate it, almost.
Yeah. Thinking even like, for example, Ayrton Senna, and he was driving the, like for him also, like driving the F1 car and all of that, and as he was driving the whole thing, it somehow became an expression of that. At this point when he was like, you start feeling so much peace at times, he's saying, I'm not my conscious understanding.
I sometimes feel like it can be a burden. If you're an artist and you're expressing genius there.
In one field.
And you don't have enough space within you to assimilate it, you'll just end up ruining other parts of your life.
I think that's why most people end up being eccentric also.
Eccentric, alcoholic, drugs and whatever.
Yeah. Like for example, Bob Dylan, I think it was a brilliant example of that. Like he was an incredible artist, but there were so many parts of his life that I think were so like flawed. And I think all of these guys, like Clapton, even back home, so many of these. Yeah.
I mean, look at what Clapton went through. It's like, for a guy who was able to channel that genius, he's gone through an awful lot. Yeah. His life should have been much easier compared to most people.
Yeah, technically. I think for me, it feels like, I was telling another person, it's like each of us have our own unique crosses designed almost.
Yeah.
Like each of our lives, it's like we can't compare it to another person, and it's almost like everything that we have to go through. Some people have to go through fame and all of that stuff. Mm. Some people may not have to deal with that, but still the intensity of few issues are, some things are more intense, some things are less intense. But it's like we all have to bear our own crosses. We all have to go through what we have to go through. But just a commitment and a dedication to see, okay, what is it that's holding me back, what's limiting me in kind of every aspect of my life.
Maybe people like artists, musicians, whatever, they're more interested in their craft than anything else.
That can be
a limit also.
But I think it's like the profit mentality. It's like, okay, if I better my craft, then I can see how it can help me. But if I better my life, I don't see the tangible results in it immediately. Yeah.
It's sad, then.
Yeah.
It's like you may be a genius, but you may be struggling completely in another aspect.
Dr. Hawkins used to say, comedians are almost messengers.
Favorite people
of God, something like this.